Hello, in this video I will talk on the recursion. In this program we have an array of integers, and then we make a call to R function, which is a recursive function. So R, let me just display this way. Okay, so it takes two parameters. One of them is it takes the entire array as a parameter. And then we say start, okay? So here we say, okay, start from the zero. So here in this recursive function, we need a base case and also the smaller part, okay? The base case would be display the first item, and the smaller part is display the rest, okay? So when we say display the rest, we need to know from which index we should start. So in the second recursive call, we say start from the second index, which is the index 1. And then you say index 2. Okay, so this is how you have the reduction. Reduction is you get to the solution or the final destination, you get closer and closer. Okay, so now let's debug this program. So I put some breakpoints in here and also in here. Let me just debug it. So let me show the breakpoints. Okay, so breakpoints are here. So let's debug that. Okay, maybe I can show like this. Okay, so here we are about to make a call to this one. Right now we are inside of the main method, and you can see that in here, okay, main method, so in the stack. So let me just step over. When I step over, I will go to the next breakpoint. Okay, from here I go to the next breakpoint, which is right here. Okay, let's go to the next one, and also let me show the value. So in here start is okay. Okay, so in here start is zero, okay, because it was zero. So display that. So let me just do this. Okay, step over. Okay, we display zero, okay, start is zero, and then we check the condition. Is zero less than length, which is 3? No, it is not. So so this is the continuation condition. Okay, so let's step over, and we display, okay, and we display the first element right away. Okay, and then we make another call, recursive call. Okay, so let's step over. Okay, it displays the first element, 70, and then we say make another recursive call again this is the same array, but in here we have the reduction, which means you get closer to the final destination. So you say pass 1, okay, so 0 plus 1, 1. Okay, so let's step over, and let's call this R0, because start is 0. Let's call this one, as you see here, it is in the stack. Let's call this R0, and when I make another call, now we are inside of the R1. Okay, so start is 1, as you see here. So we are in R1. So R0 is here. Let me click on this. As you see, start is 0. R0 is still waiting in the stack. So it is not completed yet. So this one is R1. Okay. So R0 is waiting for this to be completed, for the R1 to be completed, and then it will display index 0. Okay, but displaying index 0 is postponed. Okay, so let's look at the R1. So in the R1, we are displaying 1, okay, which is index 1. And then we check the condition. Condition is true. Okay, so step over. Now R1 will display the element at the index 1. Okay, so display that, which is 80. And then make a call to R2. Okay, so R1 is going to display 80 again, but it is postponed. Okay, so first R2 should be completed. So step over. Okay, now as you see, we are inside of the R2 and start is 2. So R1 is waiting, R0 is waiting, main is waiting. So all of them is waiting to be completed. So let's look at the R2. And so display 2 on the screen, and then display this. Okay, display the element at the index 2. Okay, now we are about to make a call to R3. Okay, R3. Okay, the index 3 does not exist in this element. So if you try to display that, it would throw the exception, which is out of bound exception. So here we say start is 3. Is it less than 3? No. In that case, if you want to do anything in here, you put it as an else statement. So this else is executed only once. But this one, this part, so executed in every recursive call. So we say no element. Okay, so let me step over. No element on the screen. Okay, so now here we started from index 0, index 1, index 2, index 3. So index 3 does not exist. It displays no element. And when we go back to main method, we visit this function, this method. And all of these, while we are going back to from right to left, we visit all of them again. Okay, so we display all of them one by one. So here no element. So when I step over, actually this will be removed from the stack. So let me just step over. Okay, it is removed. Now we are back in the R2. So R3 is completed. Now R2 is going to display the element at the index 2. So step over. Okay, as you see, it displays 95. And then when I step over, R2 is completed. It will be removed from the stack. Now we are, okay, step over. Now we are back in the R1. Okay, R1. So R1 is going to display the element at index 1. Okay, so step over. Okay, so it displays 80. And step over. Now we are in the R0. Display the index 0, which is 70. Okay, as you see, so it displays them in reverse order. And after displaying the index 0, now we are going back to main method. So so as you see here, R1 is in the stack. So this is about to removed. So let's step over. Okay, it is removed. Now we are back in the main method. And it says goodbye on the screen. Okay, it says goodbye on the screen. I hope this is clear, and have a nice day.